Good morning, student. Again in our new meeting, today we will discuss the animal tissue. It is the second part of our lecture. Most of the time I explained you in Hindi, but today I have decided to explain a little bit in English also. So today we will discuss the four topics: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and nervous tissue. Okay, so let me move on the next slide. Epithelial tissue, basically our skin, lining of mouth, blood vessels, lungs of alveoli, kidney tubules, all are basically made up of epithelial tissue. So why these are made of blood epithelial tissue? Because the epithelial tissue forms a tightly packaged. So tight packed they are. They form a continuous sheet of epithelial cells. There is no intracellular space, and just because of small cementing, the exchange of gases and some material and minerals and waste material can take place easily. That's why epithelial tissues are present in this particular area where absorption and exchange of gases is required. Okay, for example, if consider the lining of mouth, what we happen, some of the medicines that we take inside our mouth is directly get absorbed into our systemic circulation just below our tongue, because the epithelial tissue, epithelial cells are present there. Just why the directly absorption can take place. Okay, that's why epithelial tissue, they form a protective layer also, and absorption and also an exchange of gases and waste material also can take place easily. Now, first of all, basically epithelial tissue can be classified into three or four category. So first one is called simple squamous epithelium cells. When simple squamous epithelial cells, if you observe the cell, that have a flat surface from the both the side, but their boundary we can say is irregular. But when the cells combine together, they form a continuous flat surface. That's why we can say the first point I mentioned here, simple flat kind of cells. You can see the diagram also that is mentioned here in our PPT. Okay, and where they are present, present in our blood vessels, even in our lung alveoli, and even the esophagus and mouth lining is also made up of simple squamous epithelium tissue. Okay, when we call it stratified, when the multi or many layers of simple squamous combined together, it forms a thick layer. At that time we call it stratified squamous epithelium. Okay, and when they combine together, they give a specific strength to that particular tissue and particular part. Example is skin. The skin is also made up of stratified squamous epithelium tissues, because multi-layer are combined together. That's why it protects from wear and tear. That's why our skin is very tough. Okay, it protects from abrasion, and just we touch and we rub the skin, it does not affect. Okay, so we can understand what is the role of stratified squamous epithelium cell. Okay, next one is called cuboidal epithelium tissue. If you observe the diagram, first one, the simple cuboidal, what happens here, you can see this one is simple cuboidal epithelial. The cells have cube-shaped surface and having a single nucleus present. When these cube-shaped cells of epithelium combine together, they give rise to simple cuboidal epithelium tissue. Okay, and where they are present? They are present in the lining of kidney, ducts of salivary gland. Okay, one very important function is when the upper surface of these simple cuboidal epithelium moves inward, they sometimes create a cavity, and finally these cells are combined together to form, give rise to some glands like structures, and these glands secrete some secretory material. For example, the sweat gland and the salivary gland, these are the modified structures formed by our cuboidal epithelium tissue. And when the multiple layer of this simple cuboidal combine together, they give rise to stratified cuboidal. Whenever the stratified word you study, you please keep in mind that the multi-layer or many layer of the any of specific tissue combined together, we call it stratified. Okay, so there should not be any kind of doubt. Okay, next we move on the next, but you keep in mind the diagram. That's why we can easily remind them. Okay, columnar epithelium tissue. Their shape you can see that I already mentioned, the column-shaped cell or tall or pillar-like shape. That's why we call it columnar epithelium tissue. Where it is present in intestine. And what happens in the intestine? Because just by the location, we can identify what is the function of that particular epithelium tissue. Because they are present in intestine, so absorption and digestion take place. So their main function is absorption. And second function for digestion of food, what is required? The secretion of some enzymes also. That's why their second function is secretion. So you can note down their function is absorption and secretion. Okay, one very important function, some of the body parts, for example, lungs, alveoli, inside the fallopian tube of female reproductive tract, this columnar epithelium cells contain some cilia-like structure. Cilia are very small projections, finger-like projections present over the surface, and they give a unidirectional movement. Okay, so what happens if any foreign particle, dust particle, enter into the respiratory tract and the mucus cell secretes some mucus and that covers the that foreign body. And finally, the cilia gives a unidirectional movement. They move that mucus covered foreign body in one direction, and finally what happens? It moves out of the respiratory tract. So cilia containing columnar epithelium cells are present in our respiratory tract, alveoli, and even in the fallopian tube of female reproductive tract. What is the role there? It moves the ovum toward from the ovary towards the uterus. Okay, so it is especially for movement of the specialized functions is performing. Okay, now we move on the next one. You please keep in mind the small diagram and cilia. Okay, now last one, sorry, columnar is already we have done connective tissue. It is the second one part. Okay, connective tissue, what is the basic role of connective tissue? Connective means any tissue which combines the other organs or other systems, that is called connective tissue. If we take the example of blood, what is the role of blood, friend? It connects all the organs. It transports the oxygen and CO2 from lungs to other tissue and from tissue to the lungs for exchange. It carry the nutrient from small intestine to all part of the cells and tissue present in our body so that the cells get the energy. Okay, and even the waste material gets synthesized in our cells, in our liver, all get transported via blood to the kidney so that the nitrogenous waste can be released out, okay, removed from the blood. So blood is a connective tissue. Okay, now first of all, we must understand what is the composition of blood. If we consider the blood volume is 100%, then 55% of the volume is made up of plasma, a yellowish like fluid that contains all the protein, salts, enzyme, hormone, all of that. Remaining 45% of the blood is a solid part, and it is made up of three kind of cells. One is called RBC, that is already I mentioned in my PPT, that RBC is called erythrocyte. It is red just because of hemoglobin pigment that is present inside. Okay, and main role of RBC is carrying oxygen and CO2 in the body. Okay, from lungs to tissues and from tissue to the lungs for gaseous exchange. And second one cell is called WBC, we call it leukocyte, and we have already studied in 8th class and earlier classes that WBC is performing the mechanism of body defense mechanism. That means they kill the foreign particle, bacteria and all the things that are dangerous for our body. Okay, so body defense mechanism function they perform. Okay, let us we move on the third one, platelets. It is the smallest in size, does not contain any nucleus, and they form inside our small intestine, and their main role is clotting of blood from the injured part, because they contain vitamin K and calcium that initiate the process of thrombosis, that means clotting. So they help in clotting of blood over the injury. Okay, the next one, already the function are explained to you, removal of nitrogenous waste, carry oxygen and CO2 for exchange, and even the blood carry transport salts, mineral, hormone, enzyme, drugs to all of the tissue of the body. And you can see the diagram also, these all are the types of WBC. One is called neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil, lymphocyte, monocyte. All these are WBC. These are WBC. And this one is the platelets. RBC is not mentioned in the diagram. Okay. Now we move on the next slide. This is connective tissue, second connective tissue, bone. Very, very important for our body and gives us mechanical strength. Okay. The bone is a tissue made up of a special kind of cells called osteocytes. Osteo word means actually bone, and cytes means cells. So osteocyte means the cells which form the bone. Okay, bone is cell is which is embedded in the heart. Embedded means it is fixed inside a heart matrix, and that matrix contain the high level of calcium and phosphorus. Okay, that's why the bones are very, very strong. Okay, mechanical strength just because of the these one minerals, calcium and phosphorus. That's why the milk is very, very important for us. Okay, and what are which one the vitamin which helps in the absorption of calcium and phosphorus from our diet? Vitamin D. I think you know that. Okay, let us we move on the functions. So what is the role of skeletal system? Bones form the skeletal system, help in locomotion and movement, and even it protects the internal delicate organ. Okay, let us we see, it is a rib cage. This part, and these are the 12 pair of ribs. All of the organs situated inside is called like lungs, and heart is situated inside the rib cage. That's why rib cage protects the internal delicate organ from injury, from shock. That's why very, very important. And without locomotion, and this we can say it gives a mechanical sense. That's why we can move from one place to another place. That's why bones are very, very important. And in this diagram, is taken from NCRT, very important. You can observe these is the system is called Harvestian canal. If you prepare the slide of our bone, we can say this kind of cells are present, and these black cells are called canaliculi and osteocyte cells. This is the structure of bone. Okay, now you can easily understand from this diagram also. Now move on the next page. Ligament and tendons present with bones. Ligament, first of all we must understand, because bones are joined with the elastic tissue, that is called ligament. Okay, if you want to see the ligament, just you touch your feet behind the ankle and your calf, what happens is small tough tissue is present. Okay, that is called a ligament which joins the bone to bone, and that's why it have a specific stance, and that's why we can move easily. Second one is called tendon. It joins the bone to muscles. All the muscles, you can see the diagram, this tendon, this white one is a tendon. Okay, it joins the bone to muscles. It have a great specific strength, but its flexibility is limited. As compared to this one, ligament, it is very elastic. I mention here, it is very elastic, but tendon is limited flexibility, but having great strength. You can see the diagram. These are called ligaments that joins the bone to bone, and these are white structure are called tendons that join the muscles and bone. Okay, we can understand from the diagram also. These are basically our connective tissue. Now next one is called cartilage. You can observe the cartilage. If you touch your ear pinna, that is also made of cartilage. If you touch your nose and you can move here and there, that is also made up of cartilage. Even between our vertebral column, the cartilage discs are present. Every time we heard they have a disc problem, basically that are made of cartilage. And what is the role of cartilage? It gives a specific movement, flexibility, and specific having the strength also, and they reduce the jerk and shock. Okay, I already mentioned here in point that they reduce the effect of jerk and shock. They are present between bones and also reduce the friction between bones. Okay, what happens in old age cases, the people sometimes feels pain in their knees. What, just because of what? When the femur bone and the other our tibia and fibula and patella, between them a disc of cartilage is present. Due to the time period, when this cartilage become damaged or very, very weak, this the nerves and the bones when rub with each other, that cause a pain. Okay, so healthy diet and healthy exercise is very, very important to maintain the structure of cartilage, and sitting in a right portion is also important to maintain the shape of our disc that is present between our backbone and vertebral column. Okay, I already mentioned this point, you can understand easily. Okay, next one, this already I mentioned, that is present in nose, ear, pinna and trachea. You can observe this one also. Okay, the cells which forms the cartilage, that is called chondrocytes. Chondrocytes, that you keep in mind. This is very important. 1 marks question can came in many competitive exam and your 1 marks question during the exam session. So the bone which form the cell which forms the bone is called osteocyte, and the cell which forms the cartilage, that is called chondrocytes. You keep in mind, please. Very important. And we call the cartilage is hyaline cartilage. Okay, now move on the next slide. This is called adipose tissue. Okay, adipose, if we bifurcate this word, we from there we can understand adipose, in which we can deposit something. It is a very easy way to understand. Okay, basically adipose tissue, a special kind of made up of cells that have a large vacuole size to store fat globules. I already mentioned here, you can see this is the structure of adipose cell. When adipose cells combine together, it will give rise to adipose tissue. And if you observe their central area, that is vacuole-like structure, and it contains fat globule, that is already mentioned in the diagram. Okay. And even what is the name of this cell? Adipocytes. Site word I already told you in the first slide, that site word means cell, and adipose means the cells which can store fat. Okay. Where this is present? You can observe the adipose tissue is present below our skin also, even in our internal organ, at our thigh, at our tummy, at our shoulder, everywhere adipose tissues is present. So whatever the extra fat we consume in our diet, that is directly transported to this tissue for storage, and they perform very important function. First, when the fat is get stored into this cell, they perform insulation. That means these tissue protect us from outside cold environment, so insulation. Okay, and second thing, it keeps the body warm. Okay, because the internal heat which is generated into our cells by the oxidation of glucose, that does not comes outside, and it keeps the heat inside our body. That's why our body remains warm for a long period of time. That's why the fatty diets and oily diet is necessary in the winter season. And very important thing, if the fatty tissues are present, adipose tissue is present in adequate quantity, it reduces the jerk on falling, and sometime it protects us from breaking down of our bones while we slip down or sometime we get injured. It protects us because it reduces the effect of shock, and that's why it protects us. Okay, so cells keep in mind adipocyte, very important. Okay, let us we move on our next slide, areolar tissue. Okay, sometime if you have any small, we can say, abrasion on your skin, you observe that a white color matrix like structure can be observed under the skin. Okay, that is called the areolar tissue. Basically, it is present below the skin, and it joins the outer skin with the muscles. That's why we can say it is present between skin and muscle. It joins the skin with the muscles, areolar tissue. And you observe that it is rich in fibroblast cell. Now, what is the role of fibroblast cell? It secretes the fiber that give a specific strength to the areolar tissue. Okay, here is reticulate. Reticular fibers are present, even macrophages. What is macrophages? It is a special kind of WBC that can change the shape, and from their systemic circulation capillaries, these WBC can change their shape, enter into the tissues and part, and these protect from, they perform a body defense mechanism also. These macrophages and basophil also, they engulf the foreign particle, bacteria and whatever the thing which is present or enter into the body, and that moves in the systemic circulation or under below our tissue level. Okay, collagen fibers are also present. These collagen fibers are secreted by these fibroblast cells. Now, mast cell are also present. Mast cells, their role is in allergy basically. I think you have seen a mosquito bite, and after some time the swelling get created there, because these mast cells and the basophil cells, whenever any foreign particle, foreign thing or can chemical enter into the body at particular area, a allergic reactions creates, and finally that skin portion become red. These are just because of the chemicals secreted from this mast cell, some macrophages, basophil. These are the local hormones secreted there that initiate the chemical reaction and that cause allergic reaction. Okay, they basically their role is not to create the allergy, basically it their role is to stop the allergy, okay, to protect the our body. Even plasma cells are also present, and areolar tissues also supplied with the nerves also, so that if any kind of injury we can feel the pain and feel the internal space. That is the main role of areolar tissue. It also protects and internal supports the internal organ and rip. Even if skin get injured, it supplies all the proteins and materials and WBC. And finally, what happens when all the WBC protein gets supplied to that particular injured area, the skin healing can be easy. That's why they involve in repair of tissue. And also I already mentioned they are rich in macrophages, collagen fiber. Sorry, this is spelling is mistake by it is collagen fibers and fibroblasts and mast cell. Okay, let us we move on the next slide. Muscular tissue. This is the third one, tissue, muscular tissue. Basically, muscular tissue, according to their shape and size and their function and their location, it is classified into three category. Okay, three names: striated, smooth, and cardiac. Okay. What is the role? They are made of muscular cells. Muscular tissue is made up of muscular cells. For example, striated muscles are made up of striated fibers, basically. Smooth muscles tissue is made of smooth cells, and cardiac muscles are made up of cardiac cells. Okay. Now they are all are basically, sorry, this is elongated big size fibers. They helps in body movement also, and they rich in very important protein. The question came in exam also, contractile protein. Muscular tissue contain and rich in contractile protein. That's why it help in contraction and relaxation. Okay, that is very important point. Now move on the next one, muscular type. First one type, this is called skeletal tissue. Okay, name the name skeletal tissue. That means it is present attached to our skeletal system. Okay, striation, you can see, observe these and the striations are present. Even the this is peripheral nucleus is present. Shape is cylindrical, parallel, non-branch, all are parallel attached to each other. Okay, even nucleus you can observe, this one nucleus, this one, these are multinucleated. Okay, and skeletal tissue, that's why attached, present attached to bones, we can understand easily. And these are in function, if we consider, it is control is in our hand. That means these are controls and perform the function under our will. If we want, we want to move, then they will move. If we say I don't want to move, then the muscle does not perform the function. That's why we call them voluntary. They perform the function under our control, but their action is very fast. If we compare all the muscle, their action is very, 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 very fast. That's why this is very important. You can observe the diagram. This is skeletal tissue. Okay, we move on the next one, cardiac muscles. Basically, only they are present in our heart. Cardiac means basically heart. So these cells form the heart layers. That's why we call it cardiac muscles. Okay, present only in heart. Second, if you observe that shape, these are cylindrical, parallel. Even the branch are present. These are branch and intercalated disc are present. These are intercalated disc. They are branched and connected with each other. That's why their coordination and control is very, very fast. Work in very important function. Okay, they are involuntary. They are not in our control of our will. They works automatically. Okay, they does not work perform under our control. They are work automatically. That's why we call it involuntary in nature, involuntary in function. Okay, and cardiac muscle help in the function of heart. Okay, we keep in mind. And as compared to their speed, as compared to skeletal muscle, their speed is as very, very, we can say intermediate, little bit less, because we know that in 60 seconds our heartbeat is approximately 72 to 85, depends upon the age. So their function is little bit different as compared to our skeletal muscles. Okay, so diagram is very important in this case of cardiac muscles, and where they are present, only in our heart. The next one is our smooth muscles, friend. This is smooth muscle. Okay, their shape, if you can observe, this is the shape. They have a spindle shape. because I have this in diagram, it contains four cells, four nucleus, spindle shape. They are thick at the center and thin at the corner. Uninucleated, single nucleus is present, spindle shape, so all these 3 points are covered. Okay, so where they are present in hollow organ, like blood vessel they are present. Okay, and their function is involuntary, not in control of our will. They can work automatically. For example, peristalsis, you know, it is a rhythmic contraction and relaxation in smooth muscles that move the food in forward direction in alimentary tract, our digestive system. So can we control that movement? No, it is involuntary, not in control of our will. Okay, so that is an involuntary function, and smooth muscles are present also there also. And speed of slowest as compared to skeletal and cardiac, their speed is very, very less as compared to all these three muscles, skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles, smooth muscles have very less speed. Okay, so move on next. And the last one is our neuron and nervous tissue. Basically, it is a single neuron or nerve cell. Okay, so we discuss the, this is part is called cytoplasm, we can say this part is called cell body or cyton. Cell body or cyton. These small projections are called dendrite, already mentioned the name. And in center, it is called nucleus. And the longest dendrite, which is arising from there, you can see diagram, this is called axon. This is called axon, okay. And end part of this axon is called small ending, that is called nerve endings. From there, the impulse or electric impulse can be transported to other neuron or the muscle, okay. And this covering you can observe over the this axon is called myelin sheath. Myelin sheath is an insulating material that does not allow the impulse to release out inside the nearby tissues, okay. It is an insulation over the axon. Okay, now you can say, see diagram also and the points also, made up of nerve cells or neurons. Our brain, spinal cord and peripheral nerves are made up of this nervous tissue. Okay, and main function is convey electrical impulse or signals from one part of the body to our brain and from brain to our part of the body. Okay, their main function is control and coordination, so that all the tissues and organ can work in proper coordination. And their body part already discussed with you. Okay, so I explained to you all the tissue. In this lecture, we have discussed the remaining part of this chapter, animal tissue complete we have discussed. You can note down the points mentioned by me, and you can maintain the diagram in your notebook, and even it will help you in exam also. If you see again and again, it will be easily memorized to you. So if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and give the like also, that can motivate me to make more and more. And which method you like more, please mention me in your comment, that unite the whiteboard or blackboard method or this presentation method, or whether you like to hear all the notes and lectures in Hindi or English, because most of the time I made in Hindi and sometime I make in English also, because some of my students have conveyed the message that please make the lecture in English also and Hindi also, but more in Hindi. So as you wish, if you motivate me, if you like and subscribe my channel, I will make more and more video, and you are welcome in my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day. If you like, please subscribe my channel, The Easy Way by D. Bhavani Singh. Again, we will meet in the next our video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.